Or whatever.
Welcome back, everybody. I've had this pile for quite a while. I don't even know who's in here. I think there are some duplicates of dinos, even. So we won't be opening duplicates, but I will show you what I've got here. And I think we're just going to get started. Most of these are dino escapes. They might all be dino escapes. I think there's a few Camp Cretaceous in here, too. Anyway, first up we have the Alioramus. You can see the dino escapes are all in this package here with the Dino Escape logo on the front and Jurassic World logo in the back. And they all have the kind of broken fence backdrop. Hi, Kala. The dino escapes were all called Wild Packs. I cannot remember if I've opened this or not. This might be a duplicate, so I'm going to set this one aside until I can figure it out. Alright, I know this isn't a duplicate. This is the Shringosaurus. They have a nice collection shot on the back. Ramphorhynchus Shringosaurus, Mononychus, and Velociraptor. That's the green Velociraptor. Some of those are probably in this pile, but let's open this Shringosaurus and get a better look. And there it is. That's a strange looking creature, isn't it? It's cool. Has kind of a Dimetrodon head, except it's got horns on the top. Some nice articulation there. It will tilt up and down as well as rotating. The stance does not widen, but the legs move forward and back. It has a very Dimetrodon-ish body and a nice little spiky tail. The paint doesn't go onto the tail, but at least it's not like a hard line where it stops. And they did manage to get some paint on the head and give this kid some orange eyes with a nice black dot in the middle. This is one of the cooler figures. I don't know if it's rare or not, but it does have the old style barcode on the foot. There's a look at the barcode if you want to scan it. Again, it'll show up in your old collection instead of your new one, probably. It does have a logo on the other foot, like the rest. Nice new quote-unquote dino to add to your collection. Here's another for sure not duplicate. Let's open this Zuniceratops. Alright, here's our Zuniceratops. New Ceratopsian to the Mattel line. Nice sculpt. Nice paint. Nice detail on the front there. And again, we have an old style barcode on the bottom. So there's your Zuniceratops. Alright, I know that I have one of these already open. This is the Camp Cretaceous Gallimimus. Don't need to open that. There's another Zuniceratops. This is what happens when you get a depressive episode and you don't open things for a year. You forget what you have, and sometimes you end up with multiples. Such as this. This is another Alioramus. I did check. I don't have one of these open. The one I have open is the 2019 version with the red on the face and not the orange and brown. So I'm going to go ahead and open this one. There we go. There's a nice Alioramus. Same articulation and sculpt as before, just a little bit different paint. Can see the arms and legs move, the jaw moves, and the head moves. There's a front view, side view, top view, other side. And here's that old style barcode on the foot. Here's my extra Troodon. I think I was gonna repaint this guy. Not sure, but I know I have one of these open already, so we're not going to open this right now. We are going to open this beautiful Rhymphorhynchus. Here's the barcode on the bottom of the wing. Again, since these are older, this is the older style. And here is the figure. We have some nice head articulation. We can close and open the jaw. Fish eater if I ever saw one. And look at the wings on this kid. Aren't those beautiful? It's like a monarch butterfly. Beautiful, beautiful. Nice pattern on the upper body. Now the back, kind of lackluster, but at least they did make the tip of the tail black. And I think, yeah, it's got a joint where it was assembled, but it's not posable. It doesn't move. But the back legs do. So you can bend his back legs. And of course the wings do the whole up and down, roll around thing, like all the flyers have. Same sculpt as before when we had Rhymphorhynchus, but I like the paint on this one a whole lot. Beautiful. Just beautiful. Look at that. Nice. Here we have another Hararosaurus. I have so many of these. I think I decluttered and gave about 5 to the kids recently, so I'm not going to open this one either. But I did get it as part of the Dino Escape collection, and originally had planned to open it and keep it, but I think I've changed my mind on this one. We can even sort of still do the barcode. Maybe that'll work for you, I don't know. But anyway, that's the Dino Escape Hararosaurus, kind of a bluish green with the orange bottom jaw. Here's another flyer. This is the Dimorphodon with similar paint scheme as the Rhymphorhynchus. So we're going to open this one. Here's that old style barcode. And, you know, I've got 3 or 4 Dimorphs. They keep coming out with new repaints of this kid. This one's really pretty. Zoom in here so you can see it a little better. Isn't that lovely? Nice tiger stripes. Even the tail has nice stripes on it. Not as pretty on the underside of the wings as the Rhymphorhynchus, say, but the head on this is just so nice. So there's our last Dino Escape Dimorphodon. Here's a Camp Cretaceous green Velociraptor Dino Escape, so I am going to open this one as well. You know, I collect raptors, and I have one of every raptor released in my collection. I may have given some of them to the children recently, but they were the ones going to inherit them anyway, so. Anyway, here we go. For some reason, I really like that. It goes down onto the tail, across the top of the body. Not on the legs, unfortunately, but that's how it goes with these wild packs. The head doesn't tilt up and down, but it does have a posable jaw. Nice orange painted eye with the eye slit as a pupil. And the arms don't pivot outward, but they do go back and forth, as well as the legs. These are just basic figures. They don't have any sort of action feature, but they are posable. Nice addition to my raptor collection. Even the alignment on the mouth is good, so that's nice. So that's going to do it for our Dino Escape Wild Packs. I think that's the last of the Wild Packs, and I have some other Camp Cretaceous stuff left, but we're getting to the point where we might actually be caught up on our pandemic backlog. Hope that you've been enjoying the videos. If you have, please give us a like, and don't forget to share this video with someone who collects dinosaurs and might be interested in looking at some of the past releases. There's more than like 200 and some videos on my Jurassic collection list now. So plenty of content to go and watch and see what Mattel has put out, as well as some older things from Hasbro and Kenner, too. Thank you for joining me. Until next time, happy hunting.